everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we're installing our wooden arbor. This is the one we assembled in our living room, and it's nice and sturdy, and we wanted to put it outside and be sure that it's anchored correctly. So the first thing Rick did was to put these 2x4 pieces of wood underneath it to give it a wider base, and he used stainless steel screws to anchor this into the actual arbor on both sides.
And then, who do we call? Ghostbusters either.
No, we didn't call Ghostbusters. We called the Diggers Hotline. And we were scheduled for them to come on Tuesday afternoon. But because the fellow from Diggers Hotline was very efficient, I really gave him a lot of credit. He got the assignment, he made out his slip of who he was going to. He was in the neighborhood, and instead of waiting until Tuesday afternoon, he was here Friday morning. He decided that he would do us right away too. So we thank him highly for being that efficient, because now we can carry on.
So he was kind enough to flag this for us. And so once he flagged it, then what we're doing is we're taking 5-foot threaded stock and have a couple washers, a nut on top, and after he did all of his marking and we did our measurement, we were able to sink these 5-footers down into the ground.
Right. Now we will have to move this one piece of slab here, because we decided we wanted to go straight
to center
into the pathway.
Yeah.
We knew there was a cable line under here, nothing else, just the cable line.
And
we
knew
where it started and we knew where it ended, but we weren't sure how it got there. It did not go crow's flight straight.
Well, I know we put a little stake, if I can find it
here,
right,
it is
here.
It's over here.
Yep. Just to help us remember, and I think we had painted it yellow, didn't we?
At one point, yes. And it always would pop up in the frost, after the frost of winter would be sticking up out of the ground. So it must go like this.
Yeah, it
does.
But
we only are concerned with the very entrance. And now that we know where it is, we're going to be able to finish this off and be secure and be safe at the same time.
Well, get your little sledgehammer there and show everybody how you put these into the ground.
Ha.
What do you mean, ha ha?
Ha ha. That's what I said, ha ha.
I pity the man who messes with my wife.
Never sneak up on a gardener.
Hey, who needs a gym membership, right? Well, by the magic of video, somehow these will be down into the ground shortly.
Mm-hmm. See how easy that was? And it didn't take me a time at all.
I think you did that in less than 30 seconds, right?
Thanks, yes.
All right, amazing.
I'm good.
Well, we knew that. Well, now you're going to move the stone, huh?
Yep.
Okay. You know, I think when we center this stone, that flag is going to be almost at the edge where that, or the edge of the stone is going to be exactly where that flag is. So we'll always know where it is.
We marked it on the cement.
Yeah. What if you flip it? What we'll do is we'll crack a little bit off this stone right there.
Well, we're modifying what's here so that everything fits together.
Call it the garden puzzle.
I want to take that whole thing out.
I think it has to go There we go, keep going. Okay. We'll get it in there. Stomp on it once. Mm. Do the river dance.
It's gonna be all crooked. It's gonna be a crooked path.
Yeah, well, at least we know that it fits in here. So how about that little one? Will that fit there? Or does that have to be modified?
Yeah, I don't like that side.
There you go. Okay, I'll take a little bit off of there.
Let's see. Yep, that'll do it.
You just have to level everything.
Mm-hmm. Well, another puzzle solved. Now that we have all of the stones laid down and placed and padded in correctly, now the arbor can be attached to the foundation. Those will be pretty. Using deck screws, Rick attached the arbor to the anchor, and we're all set. Now we, nice and sturdy. No vine is gonna knock this over.
Are you gonna do chin-ups out here?
Maybe. We're still debating, should we paint it this year? And we decided, yes, we are gonna paint it red because it's in such close proximity to the other red one. We don't know if this is treated lumber. It really doesn't matter when we start. We might try to find a paint that already has a primer in it, so it only needs to have one coat, which would be nice. But we hadn't intended to put this in today. We were just gonna have everything ready so that when the Digger's Hotline man came Tuesday afternoon, he would know exactly what we were doing and where we were doing it. But because he was so efficient and in the neighborhood, we were able to get this done today, which is great because we might be busy.
Well, I went over and asked him if he would just check it out for us. So I don't know if we were really on his schedule today, but...
No, we weren't on his schedule today. He had us for Tuesday afternoon, but since he was in the neighborhood and he was close, within walking distance, he looked at it and now he can take that off his Tuesday afternoon.
Yeah.
So that was very nice of him. We appreciate that. So... one more project done. There are many more to come. And if the rain holds off, we might get some more done.
Well, you've got some seeds to soak.
I do. I've soaked the seeds. Now they need to be planted. So that's next on our agenda. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We truly appreciate you watching and supporting us. And we'd love to hear your comments and questions. And if you'd like to become a Garden family member, put that little subscribing button there, right there.
Where is it?
It's right over here.
Where?
Over here.
Oh, right there?
Uh-huh.
A little red button?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Bye for now. We have more work to do.
More?
Yes.
You mean that pile is still out there waiting for us?
See, that can wait for a long time.
Good. Next year?
No, not that long.
Okay, well, it's supposed to rain, so I think we got this in just at the perfect time.
We did.
Well, off to the next project.
Yep. Connect with us on YouTube.